Hi everyone, I'm here at Hungamaa today for a Sunday lunch. Not just any lunch actually, but an all-you-can-eat buffet. I'm hungry already. Hungamaa is located on Barlamore Road in Chorlton, just a few minutes walk from the tram stop and 25 minutes from the city centre. Reading the menu on the doorway, it's apparent that they have a nice varied choice of food. There's a lot on there and it all looks interesting. The buffet costs £12.99 per person and half price for half-sized people, otherwise known as children. I'm not sure what to expect for that price as £12.99 for a buffet is pretty cheap, but apparently there's chats, tandoori, north and south delicacies, Indo-Chinese classics, curries and more. Let's see what we get. I'm here at 12:30 and the buffet still needs time to be prepared. I'm sat at a table and I've noticed that they've got coat and bag hooks. Nice touch. The friendly server gives me a drinks menu. I'm going to go for the classic mango lassi and a pint of cobra beer. It doesn't take long for them to serve the drinks as the place is still quiet. They bring me a cup of water in this metal beaker. It's cool and the type of thing you'd expect from an authentic Indian restaurant. The lassi looks nice and colourful. There's a generous swirl of mango in the yoghurt drink and look, they've even done some lassi art and drawn a heart for me. Aww. And the beer? Looks like beer. It looks good, so let's try. Crisp and refreshing. This should go well with a curry. The lassi is delicious. It's the perfect consistency and balance of sweetness. If any of the food is too hot, then this should do the trick nicely. The buffet is ready, so let's see what they've made. So I've got a small selection on this plate. I want to try a bit of everything first before I load up with the food I really like. This is Punjabi chole, vegetable hakka noodles, tandoori including sheet kebab and chicken tikka. There's samosa with some salad and papadum. As is usual with me, I've gone for the noodles to try first. They look really good. I think they taste really good and I wouldn't have thought that they were cooked in an Indian restaurant. Well done, Hungamaa. You can see this hole in the chicken tikka where it's been on the skewer. This looks authentic for sure, and I'm glad that this made it onto the buffet menu. I've cut through and the chicken looks like the marinade is soaked right through. The tikka is really good, it's well spiced, although a little on the drier side, but it's what I'd expect for this type of food. The sheet kebab also looks pretty good with a deep red colour. Biting in and the meat crumbles in my mouth. It's delicious and I think this is even better than the tikka. I'm happy with this and I'm definitely having some more later. Ah, the samosa. I love the way this parcel has been formed. It looks like the crumbly type and when I bite into it I get a nice slightly firm texture of the pastry and then the soft potato on the inside. I think it's really good. Perfectly seasoned and spiced and I wish I could take a few of these in my pocket for when I go home later. It's a nice surprise having papadums on the buffet menu. I remember when I used to eat at Indian restaurants and these were free. Now I can have unlimited amounts and this one doesn't disappoint either. Again, I've got a small selection of food to try. At the bottom is the lamb handi. Next to that is the butter chicken in a thick and rich orange coloured sauce with some more tandoori. And in the middle is some dal and a bature, naan bread and rice at the top. Looks good. The bature intrigues me the most. I've never seen this type of bread before. It's about as big as my face and when I try to tear a piece, the bread is kind of stretchy and almost bouncy before it pulls apart. I don't really know the best way to eat this, but dipping it into the dal, I take a bite and I think I found my new favourite thing. It's so good. I love the texture and the fact that it soaks up the dal so easily. It's lovely. Even though the piece looks quite big, it's very light with a pocket of air in the centre. It's thin and the perfect thing to eat with a sauce. Naan bread. It looks quite good too. I probably made a mistake eating this after the bature as that's going to be hard to beat and sure enough, the texture is fine, the flavour is fine, but it's not as good. Don't get me wrong, it's okay, but like I said, I tried this in the wrong order. I doubt much could beat the bature. The lamb is next for me to try. Already when I put a piece on my fork, I can tell it's super tender. Wow, this is delicious. I only put a small amount on my plate, but I'll definitely put more on for the third helping. It's so full of flavour and tender enough to just break apart with a fork. The buttered chicken looks okay. I'm not expecting anything mind-blowing, as these generally taste the same wherever you eat these. Well, not quite. This one is delicious, and I'm surprised once again at how tender and tasty the meat is. Yum. There's a small selection of dessert, including ice cream, rice pudding, and brownie. Not much variety, but for the price, I'm not going to complain. I'm pretty stuffed, and everything has been spot on so far. The rice pudding intrigues me. This isn't the dessert for everyone, but I'm generally a big fan. Consistency is a little runny, but when I take a bite, I can tell it's been cooked well as I can taste the individual grains of rice. The rice is sweet and creamy, and I'm really enjoying it. I think it's the right kind of consistency for drinking. Let's try. No, that's probably going to go everywhere. I'll just eat it the old-fashioned way. On to the ice cream. I had to ask for this as I could see that there was a label at the buffet, but no ice cream. They brought it out pretty quickly and it came in a large tub. It doesn't taste like anything special, but it's quite satisfying and a good way to extinguish some of the heat of the curries. The brownie looks okay. They kept it warm in the bain-marie and when I bite into it, I can taste rich chocolate with the right amount of gooey texture and crispy outer skin. Delicious. For just £2.50, I've ordered masala chai. I quite like chai, and I think this would be the perfect drink to end my meal. I didn't put any sugar in it, I wanted to try as it is. It's got a hit of spice, not too much though, as sometimes it can be too warming. This one's really well balanced. So in total, the bill came to £36.93 for two people. No service charge was added, even though the service was really good. The food was prepared to a high standard and the staff were always on hand, acting friendly and helpful. I can't recommend this place enough. It was definitely value for money and I can't wait to come back again. Thanks for watching, until next time, bye!